During an amazing weekend exploring the mountains of Saudi Arabia in the Al Baha region, I managed to shoot this time-lapse of the Thee Ayn village, only to find out after post-processing that the whole video was ruined by this flashing light. Now, considering the amount of effort it took to capture the moment, I was determined to save this time-lapse from the recycle bin. In this two-part video, I'll show you the technique I used to capture the scene and how I managed to save this time-lapse from potential failure. Travelling around Saudi Arabia isn't always the easiest. Even though the country has opened up to foreign visitors, it's not quite geared up for commercial tourism. There are many amazing places to visit in this conservative and often misunderstood country. One place I've been wanting to visit for quite a while is the mountainous region of Al Baha, in the western part of the country, close to the main city of Jeddah. The region is home to the Thee Ayn Heritage Village, also known as the Marble Village, which was originally built over 400 years ago. As recently as 40 years ago, people were still actually living there. My journey started with an evening flight from Dammam Airport to Jeddah, an overnight stay in Jeddah, then an early morning domestic departure to King Saud bin Abdulaziz Airport in the region of Al Baha.
Heritage Village, in all its glory, in all its midday glory.
Here I have a time-lapse setup, which is in my custom shooting mode for time-lapse photography. I have the shutter speed constrained within certain parameters. So maximum shutter speed is 1/15th of a second, and the lower shutter speed is 4 seconds. And the aperture has been constrained between f/8 and f/4.5. We're gonna see what happens with this time-lapse. Really amazing setting we have here. This is Thee Ayn in Al Baha region of Saudi Arabia. So the lights have just come on. So as the evening progresses, we should start to see those uplighters intensify and the surrounding lights diminish. And that should create a really nice kind of day to night time lapse. And also, sorry, just a quick note that the ISO has been set to auto. The highest ISO value is set to 400. So the camera's gonna get to ISO 400, and then it's gonna start to push the aperture down, and then it's gonna start to push the shutter speed down. That's the plan anyway. Let's see how it works. So this is program priority, auto exposure time-lapse, day to night time-lapse. Let's see how it works. Quick update on the program priority auto exposure time lapse. So the maximum aperture value is f/8 and the minimum was f/4. So at the moment it's kind of bouncing between f/4 and f/4.5, which is I'm perfectly fine with. The ISO value is now beginning to be pushed up. So it's now pushed up to 320. So the maximum ISO that's been set to is 400. So it's not going to go any higher than ISO 400. When it reaches ISO 400, the aperture is going to be maxed out at f/4, and it's now just switched to f/4. And the shutter speed is then going to start to decrease. So it's going to start to drag the shutter speed from 1/15th down to to what the minimum lowest shutter speed that I set, which I think was 4 seconds, if I could be wrong. We'll wait and see what happens. So you can now see that ISO value is now maxed out at 400. That is now pushing the aperture down to f4, and it's also beginning to change the shutter speed from 1/15th to 1/10th, and the shutter speed is now going to be dragged down to its lowest value. So just a quick update on the program priority custom shooting mode for time lapse. You can see now the ISO is maxed out at 400. The F value is maxed out at F4. Now the shutter speed has gone down from 1/15th to 1/3 of a second. So that's going to continue to be dragged down. Now it's the only value that's going to change is the shutter speed until we turn the time lapse off and feel that we have sufficient amount of frames. The dreaded overheat warning is now turned on the Canon R5, but I think we've got enough anyway, so it doesn't really matter. And from past experience, this hasn't really caused me any problems at all. I've managed to shoot for much longer, even with the overheat warning on. But you can see now that the shutter speed, it seems to be maxing out at 1/3 of a second, and it's ISO 400, aperture value is F4. So those two values aren't going to change now, it's just the shutter speed, and it seems to be leveling out at 1/3 of a second, so I'm quite happy with that, I've got to be honest. So probably going to give it another few minutes and then we're going to wrap up. Well, as you can see, all that effort was almost for nothing, as the flashing light in the top left almost ruined the whole time-lapse sequence. In part two, I will take you through the process of editing the video and removing that unwanted flashing light. So the time-lapse technique that I use probably wasn't explained that well earlier in the video. It is essentially a pre-programmed custom shooting mode using program auto exposure on the Canon R5 that allows the camera to record a time-lapse using a constrained set of parameters, reducing the need to manually adjust the camera's exposure settings while a time lapse is being recorded. It's a kind of auto time lapse setup that I normally use to create my sequences. This will also work just as well using the other Canon R series cameras. I have also made several other videos that help to explain how to configure the Canon R cameras using the auto time lapse method using program auto exposure set up as a custom shooting mode. Thank you.